Welcome to your introduction to Scalable Desktop. First, we're going to download and install Scalable Desktop 3.1, as well as download and save a copy of the user manual. That way there you'll have one handy and have one on file in case you ever need it. When it's finished downloading, open up the Scalable Desktop installer. Follow the on-screen prompts from the installation wizard. First, it's just going to check to make sure that all of our requirements validate. If they don't, a window is going to pop open, running through our operating system, making sure it's supported, then checking to see if we are using Windows Aero. It will install without Windows Aero, but it's recommended for its speed. Third, it's going to check to make sure that the graphics card is on Scalable's list of approved NVIDIA cards. And lastly, it's going to make sure that there is a camera plugged in, the camera is supported, and that all of the drivers have been installed. Well, looks like we don't have a camera on here. So first we're going to plug in the camera, visit our camera's website, download the drivers. Once we know all of that's done, we'll click on refresh. Once we get all the green checks, we can move on. And we'll just want to continue to follow the instructions on the screen. Alrighty, now once completed, we're going to set up our Scalable Desktop. So double click on the Scalable icon, open that up. And once it opens, we're going to want to begin the setup. So you can go ahead and click on the gears. You'll see on the left-hand side of the screen, we've got some panels. First one being projectors. We want to make sure that the arrangement of the projectors match what's on the screen. Second, we'll go down to camera. Want to make sure we have our camera there and the camera is seeing an image. The camera doesn't have an image that appears and is white. We'll just need to auto-tune that camera. You can go ahead and click auto-tune. And once it's been tuned, we'll be able to see the image. It looks like we can see our image now. So now we can begin data collection. You'll notice in our image that we don't have the full screen in view. As it's going through, it's going to realize this. It'll stop us and say you have an error. Looks like your camera can't see the entire screen. So we'll want to move the camera to make sure the screen and both of the projectors are fully seen by the camera. And then we'll want to begin that data collection again. The white images that are popping up are showing where the projectors are on the screen. The five-dot pattern is going to give the orientation and location, and then the grid pattern that pops up is going to be showing where every pixel falls. Once it completes through, we can go ahead and continue on, selecting our geometry over the screen. Our aspect ratio panel allows us to automatically correct the resolution of the display. And lastly, we'll want to adjust our image boundary. We have 4 points on here, and we'll just want to extend those to the very far edge of the screen to fill up our entire display. You can roughly move the points with your mouse to fine-tune the points. Your arrow keys work very well. And you can use your arrow key to fine-tune the points. Once we're happy with our image boundary, looks like we just want to fix that left side. Awesome. So once we've filled the entire screen, then we can do complete calibration. And then from everything we went to, we're going to have our warp and blend. If it looks correct, we'll keep the warp. You'll also notice that you have some options there at the end from our management panel that you can engage or disengage the warp, as well as recalibrate the display if it's necessary. And that is how you download, install, and start Scalable Desktop.